In this tutorial, I'll show you an easy way to create these handwritten titles for your Kinemaster video projects. You can use this technique to create different looks, from fun and colorful to dark and scary. The idea for this tutorial came from a set of colored index cards. By using the chroma key effect with the colored cards, you can separate hand-drawn text from the colored background. I used a permanent marker to draw text on the colored paper. Then I used my cell phone camera to record video of the text. Try to avoid any glare or shadows on the paper when you're recording. I shot this hand-holding both the index card and the camera, which caused a little bit of camera shake in the video. I like that the text wiggles a little bit in the final video. Just make sure you're steady enough that the text doesn't leave the frame and you can crop out anything you don't want, like my thumb here. Let's get started with the fun example. I'll tap the media button and then click background. For this example, I'll use this clouds background. Jump to the beginning of the project. Tap layer, media. Find the video of your handwritten text. If needed, you can crop the video. Check the entire clip to make sure the text doesn't go off the screen. Scale the clip to whatever size you'd like it. Then apply the chroma key effect. By default, Kinemaster did not pick the correct color for my key, so I'll manually select it here. This blue looks pretty close. The paper doesn't key out perfectly, so you'll have to fiddle with the sliders until you get what you need. When I key out the paper, the text goes a little see-through, so I'm just going to duplicate the layer. Now the black is darker, but you still can't see the paper. Playing back the video, you can see that the effect looks pretty good. Now I'll show you how I created the colorful background. Choose layer, handwriting. Pick the brush tool and use the largest size brush available. Choose a color and create random confetti dots all over the screen. Switch colors as you go. Keep going until you have something that looks roughly like this. Now select the handwriting layer and tap on the overall animation icon. Then scroll down and select jitter. Let's play that back to see how it looks. Select your text layer and tap on the menu at the left of the screen. Then tap bring to front. Do the same process for the other text layer if you had to duplicate it. The colors in the background look pretty good, but they might be a little too distracting, so I'll drop the opacity. Select the handwriting layer, then tap Alpha Opacity, and drag the slider down. Let's play that back and see how it looks. If you want to increase the amount of color or randomness in the background, you can duplicate your handwriting layer. Select the menu at left and choose Duplicate. Now I'll rotate the layer. And I'll adjust the scale. Send this new layer to the back. Let's play that back full screen so we can see how it looks. There you have a fun tie-dye look. Now let's work on the scary example. In this project, I've already imported my background footage. I've also placed a marker where a lightning bolt cuts through the frame. In order to place a marker, just tap on the playhead. To jump to a point on the timeline where you've placed a marker, long press on the playhead. Then select the time you want to jump to. The first thing I want to do is add some color correction to my footage to make it dark and spooky. Tap on the layer, then scroll down to Color Adjustment. I'll bring down the brightness, and I'll bring up the contrast. The next step is to import my text. This is where I'll jump to the marker. And I want the text to start coming on a little before this mark. Then tap Layer, Media. Navigate to your camera folder and find your text. In this case, I was holding my phone sideways, so the text came in wrong. I'll scroll down to Rotate Mirroring and rotate the clip counterclockwise. Now I'll scale up my text and apply the chroma key effect. Again, I have to change the color. And I'll adjust the mask. In order to get a clean key, I had to adjust the sliders very carefully, but I'm pretty close right here, and that will work. Next, I want to apply a color filter to change the text from black to white. Let's play that back to see how it's looking. That's not bad, but let's add some more details. First, I'll change the in animation to fade and change the time to 2.5 seconds. Then I'll change the out animation to fade as well and change the time to 1.5 seconds. Now I'll duplicate this layer. On this new layer, go to the out animation settings and change the time to 2.5 seconds. Now long press on the clip and drag on the timeline slightly to offset the timing with the first layer. Finally, select the layer and change the overall animation to flicker. There you have it, two examples of a low-tech, easy way to make handwritten titles in Kinemaster. Here's one more look at both versions. If you like this video, you can find more tutorials in my Kinemaster playlist. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel.